Hello everyone, welcome to sqadia.com. My name is Dr. Dewan and the topic of the lecture today is tissue nematode infections. In this lecture, we're going to talk about different nematodes which are present in our system and they might affect our human body and lead to tissue pathology. In this lecture, we're going to start with visceral and ocular larva migraines of T. canis. We're going to talk about what they look like, and afterwards, we're going to talk about the life cycle of it. We're going to talk about how they reach the human body, how they reach the human tissue. We're going to talk about if human is not their definite host, then what and why do they get to human body and what are the consequences of it. We're going to talk about their primary host, their secondary host, their life cycle, and how do they go along. And we're going to talk about if they get in the human body, what are the consequences. Afterwards, we're going to divide the consequences into visceral consequences and visceral clinical features and ocular clinical features. We're going to talk about what visceral clinical features it will present to us with, and we're going to talk about what ocular clinical features it will present to us with. Next on, we're going to talk about how do we diagnose this pathology, what kind of clinical manifestations will present to us with, and what kind of diagnostic tools we'll use to get to our definite diagnosis. Next on, we're going to start with the treatment. First of all, we'll define whether it's ocular or it's visceral. Ocular involvement has different treatment, and visceral involvement has different treatment options. So we'll go along the therapy once the definite diagnosis has been achieved. Next on, we're going to talk about cutaneous larva migraine, which is caused by Ankylostoma brasilensis, which is basically a nematode, and it causes most probably only cutaneous manifestations. We're going to talk about where is it found, what clinical manifestation will it present to us with. Next on, we're going to talk about angiostrongyliasis. We're going to talk about what is the causative organism of angiostrongyliasis, what's the life cycle of angiostrongyliasis, and after the life cycle, we're going to talk about what clinical features will it present to us with. We're going to talk about how only these nematodes will lead to the development of eosinophilic meningitis in our cases. How do we diagnose these patients? What are the laboratory findings you'll go for? What are the definite diagnostic modalities you'll go for? And how do we know that it's not fungal, not bacterial, not viral, but a nematodal meningitis? Next on, we're going to talk about the treatment options we have for this pathology, and afterwards we'll go for the gnathostomiasis, which is caused by what organism. We're going to talk about that, what's the life cycle of it, how many hosts does it go through, how does it reach the human body, what kind of pathological manifestation does it present to us with, what clinical features you look for, what's the diagnostic modalities we use, and how do we treat such patients in medical terms as well as in surgical terms. So for watching this complete lecture and a variety of lectures, which range from anatomy, physiology, pathology, microbiology, pharmacology, medicine, surgery, there are thousands of lectures. You can avail trial lectures in which you can accommodate yourself. So for availing all of this, please subscribe to sqadia.com.